They don't know I got the trap going on like, oh, they don't know I got the trap going on like. Welcome back, YouTube. If you just tuned into my channel, thank you for watching. My name is Magda Civil, fitness motivator and also health coach. Need health and fitness advice? Feel free to visit my website, Magda Civil Fitness. I have a lot of plans on there available to help you along your fitness goal. So one of the things I want to share with you is suffering or having to go through a miscarriage. The first time I was ever pregnant, my husband and I, we suffered a miscarriage. So one of the things suffering a miscarriage, I honestly did not know what was going on the day that it happened. I was scared, and I never forget exactly how it went down. I sat down and came home, and I sat next to my husband, and I felt really cold, and I was shaking, and I was like, I don't know, I don't feel good. And he asked me, Magda, what's wrong? I said, I don't know, I'm not feeling well at all. At this point, I was 6 weeks pregnant, and I already knew I was pregnant, but I didn't really, it was my first pregnancy, and I was just so excited. I shared the news with everyone. When I found out, you know, my husband, he shared the news with all his friends, and I didn't really post anything online yet. I wanted to wait till after my first doctor's appointment before I post anything online. So going through that whole miscarriage situation, I was home. I was actually sitting on this couch right here. My husband, he sat right next to me, and I felt tired, I was cold, and I felt a lot of cramping at the same time. And I sat on the couch, and I was just confused. Like, I don't know, I'm just not feeling good. The symptoms felt very similar to if you ever had menstrual cramps. It felt very similar to that. So I sat down on the couch, and I said, you know what, babe, I don't feel good. I don't feel good. He's like, well, what's wrong? I don't know, I just don't feel well. So I just wrapped myself in a blanket, and I fell asleep. And I woke up thinking I would feel better, but I didn't. That night, the cramping just started getting worse and worse, and I really felt like I was having menstrual cramps. I woke up in the middle of the night, went to the bathroom, and I seen just so much blood just coming out of me. And I was scared, because some people say that, well, you know what, during your pregnancy you're gonna spot a little bit, or you may see a little bit of blood. Some people say that the blood that they see during pregnancy, it may be similar to your period, you'll be fine. But that following morning when I woke up, it was still a lot of blood that was just coming out, almost very similar to my menstrual cycle. So I sat down and I looked at my husband and I said, well, what do you want to do? I think we should go to the hospital, because I think I'm having a miscarriage. Good thing we did go to the hospital, because this is where I learned a lot about myself that I did not already know. And it's a good thing to always find out what your blood type is, because for years, my mother, she always told me I was B positive. And this is an experience that I want to share with most people, because I'm not sure if a lot of people know about the Rh factor. So we went to the hospital, they did the blood test, they performed an ultrasound, and they did a urine test. And everything came back just as I expected. They confirmed that I was having a miscarriage. And this is the part where I was completely mind blown when they came up to me and they said, well, Magda, you're Rh negative. Well, and I was just confused. And they confirmed, like, yes, Magda, you are Rh negative, meaning that this Rh factor, if they link it to the Rh monkey, and most people have that positive blood type. So that's why you're Rh negative, because you don't come from that rhinoceros monkey bloodline. They are actually still doing research to figure out where negative blood type ancestry line comes from. After finding out that I was Rh negative, when people who are Rh negative, it is imperative, first of all, whenever you're going through a miscarriage, always go to the hospital, because you never know what you're going to find out. The Rogaine shot is to help to prevent people who are Rh negative from being sensitized from positive blood type. See, this is what happens. When you are Rh negative and you have a baby and a baby is Rh positive, what happens is your body notices that there's something foreign going on inside, and your body automatically attacks the baby because it doesn't know what it is. You're negative and the baby blood type is positive. So the Rogaine shot synthesizes positive antibodies so that your body won't attack the baby if its blood type is Rh positive. Post miscarriage, it was definitely emotional for me because, first of all, let me put it this way. I did not know that I would be extremely emotional simply because I really didn't have an attachment with the embryo. I didn't feel any kicking. I felt normal, you know, it was just like a normal situation. So for me, I didn't really have that connection or that motherly connection yet. But post miscarriage, it really took a toll on me. You develop hormones that are called HCG levels that increases during pregnancy that helps you to become more maternal, that helps women to become more maternal. And in those moments when I had the miscarriage and because I was Rh negative, I had to continuously go back to get blood tests and blood work done so that I can make sure that all my HCG, I can make sure that the HCG levels are completely down. And the reason for this is because the doctors want to prevent something that's called an ectopic pregnancy. And that's when the embryo is implanted into the fallopian tube, and that can cause more health complications in the long run. And they wanted to make sure that I was completely fine. So when I went back the first time, I went back for a blood test 3 times post miscarriage, and it was just a reminder, okay, Magda, you don't, you know, you're not pregnant anymore. And not only that, I noticed changes in my body. I still had the soreness in my breast and my HCG levels were decreasing. And it definitely took a toll on me. I didn't want to keep being reminded that I wasn't pregnant anymore, or that I was going through this miscarriage. And not only that, I definitely scared myself doing a lot of research with the Rh negative blood type, because when I was researching this, I'm like, okay, I need to find somebody that's going through what I'm going through because I need some help to just figure out what I can do in the future. Came across this article that explained that people with Rh negative blood types, they have a 50-50 chance of having a stillbirth. When I read that, my mind just went, like, I just went completely numb. I started crying. I was just like, you know, it's one thing to have to deal with the miscarriage, but then to carry a child and to not know if it's going to survive or to potentially go through that, that was just mind-blowing to me. So I really went through an emotional roller coaster when I found all this information out. Because I was in an emotional state, I had to calm down. And I went back the next day to reread the article. And from my understanding, this is what I found out. Being that I'm Rh negative and I had a miscarriage, it's important that I get the Rogaine shot. Because if there are Rh positive antigens that are still in my body from the miscarriage, what happens is the fact that I'm negative, I become sensitized to Rh positive blood. And at that point, if I didn't get the shot, what happens is when I go back the next time and I find out that I'm pregnant, it makes it more complicated because the shot won't work because I'm already sensitized to the Rh positive blood type, and that increases my chances of having a stillbirth or anything. So when I went back and I read that information, I was like, okay, you know what? Thank God that, you know, my husband and I, we went to the hospital, because I'm one of those people that I don't like hospitals. Honestly, I don't. And honestly, for me at the time, when I was having a miscarriage, the first thought that came to mind was, okay, people have miscarriages all the time. Like, what can the hospital actually do for me at this point? Like, the baby is gone. You know, you can't save it. You're not gonna do any type of surgery or stitching or anything like that. What can they possibly do? Due to my own ignorance, I was able to really gain some more knowledge and understanding to why it's so important to definitely go to the hospital when a miscarriage occurs, or just to even know your blood type and understand, you know, your husband's blood type. But it's definitely different if Your husband is Rh negative and the mom is Rh positive. Those problems won't occur. Those problems mostly occur to mothers who are Rh negative and the fathers are Rh positive. So that's definitely one experience that I wanted to share with you guys. I was waiting a while to tell you. And again, this is one of the reasons why right now I'm currently pregnant, almost 4 months pregnant now. And I know that now I had the Rogaine shot prior to the pregnancy, and then I get another shot at 28 weeks. So I'm actually excited for what the future will bring. I'm definitely happy. We did all the testing for the baby. Everything came out negative. Thank God the baby is a healthy growing baby, and we're excited for what the future will bring. And I'm excited to share the journey with you guys. So thank you so much for listening to my experience. I hope that I was able to share or touch somebody out there who's experiencing the same thing that I'm going through. Because a lot of times during pregnancy, people are going through a lot, but they don't really have a voice to or audience to reach out to. So for me, it's important to just share the knowledge and experience that I've experienced so that I can touch and help somebody else who's going through the same thing too. All right, you guys, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Take care.